to the Sins Review. I'm your host, Jackie Sins. So yeah, I kind of went over in my head how to do this. First, I was just going to review the original Halloween from 1978, and then review other films related to the holiday. I would then review one film in the Halloween franchise every year on October. However, Halloween Kills, the sequel to Halloween 2018, which is a sequel to the original 1978 Halloween, which retcons all the other Halloweens, it's being released this month. So I decided to start my review of the Halloween franchise in regards to the newly established canon. Of course, we'll be starting with the classic that started it all back in 1978, John Carpenter's Halloween. Most of you have probably already seen this film like a gazillion times like me, because, you know, love slashers. We all know who Michael Myers is. We know Laurie Strode and Dr. Loomis. This movie is a horror classic. What's even more amazing is how low budget it was at $300,000. They earned way more than twice that at the box office at $60 million. Halloween opened the doors for films like Friday the 13th, Terror Train, The Burning, Sleepaway Camp, and more. Don't worry, I haven't forgotten about A Nightmare on Elm Street. The major characters in Halloween include
Laurie Strode, played by Jamie Lee Curtis, Dr. Samuel Loomis, played by the late, great Donald Pleasance.
These are two very iconic characters. I would even say
Laurie Strode is the most iconic character Jamie Lee Curtis has ever played. Dr. Loomis is the most iconic character Donald Pleasance has ever played.
His performance really hits home just how dangerous and evil he knows Michael Myers to be. While I'm at it, the killer,
Michael Myers, otherwise known as The Shape, has been played by a few different actors throughout the series.
I believe Tony Moran was simply the adult Michael without the mask and coveralls, and Nick Castle was Michael as The Shape with the outfit and the mask. Anyway, Michael is one of the biggest horror icons alongside Freddy and Jason. So the film's opening credits include the iconic theme music that would be used throughout the franchise. In fact, the soundtrack was composed by John Carpenter himself, and it is just fucking awesome. I love it. When we get to the intro, it is Halloween night, 1963, in Haddonfield, Illinois. We are treated to a point-of-view camera perspective, which was pioneered by the makers of Peeping Tom and the makers of Black Christmas, and has been utilized in other slashers. We are seeing everything from the killer's perspective, and yeah, the killer, and you know who that is. Michael Myers. And, you know, it's obviously, you know, not really a spoiler. I mean, even if you never heard of this movie before, I mean, it's on the description, the back of the DVD case here, and, you know, it's even the description on the Google search, and, yeah, I'm pretty sure it was also mentioned in the trailers as well. So, again, slashers, you know, characters are gonna be killed. In this time of 1963, Michael is 6 years old. He takes a big kitchen knife, goes to the bedroom of his 17-year-old sister, Judith Myers, and stabs the shit out of her. There is a decent amount of blood in this kill, even though we don't see details like puncture wounds. But remember, this was a low-budget film. So don't expect a lot of gorgasms as this film goes on. The focus is primarily on atmosphere and genuine creepiness and foreboding. And subtlety helps a lot with that. In other words, this is a case of less is more. 15 years go by, and we are finally introduced to Dr. Samuel Loomis, along with
Nurse Marion Chambers, played by Nancy Stevens.
They are driving to a mental hospital known as Smith's Grove on the rainy night of October 30th, 1978. Michael is set to be transferred for a court date, and Loomis and Chambers are the ones who are supposed to transport him. Here's where we get a good idea about how well Dr. Loomis knows Michael. In fact, he was previously Michael's therapist. He explains to Nurse Chambers that Michael has not spoken to anyone in years. Nurse Chambers asks what drug to give Michael before taking him before the judge. Dr. Loomis says Thorazine. And Nurse Chambers says he'll barely be able to sit up. And Dr. Loomis says, that's the idea. So already we can tell just how certain Sam Loomis is about how evil and dangerous Michael Myers is. Well, he even refers to Michael as it, and when he says all these things, it's very subtle and not so dramatic. This shows that the good doctor knows what he's talking about and says it plainly. Just when these two arrive close to the entrance, there are patients walking around. Again, there's subtlety. You know, we know something's wrong, but that doesn't mean we have to have super dramatics like, I don't know, patients running amok or something. Anyway, shit goes down, Michael attacks, steals the car. Dr. Loomis is certain that Michael, the evil, will return to his hometown of Haddonfield. With Michael arriving in Haddonfield, surely no one there is safe on Halloween. The film skips to Halloween Day, and we are introduced to
Laurie Strode, who is dropping off the key to the Myers house for her father, who is a realtor, on her way to school.
Laurie is supposed to be in high school, but you know, she looks more college age, and you know, I don't mean anything by saying this, but you know, she just kind of looks a little too old to be, you know, in high school, but it seems like she's at least a high school senior. We are also introduced to Laurie's friends.
Annie, played by Nancy Loomis, and Linda, played by PJ Souls.
There are also children like
Lindsay Wallace, played by a very young Kyle Richards, and Tommy Doyle, played by Brian Andrews.
That's pretty much all the major ones. The original Halloween is a classic for a reason. Now, I realize it might not to be everyone's taste, and that's fine, you know, everyone's entitled to their opinion. I like a lot of the other Halloween films as well, even Season of the Witch, even though it has no relation to the rest of the series, and never mind. I give the original 1978 Halloween full sins. Till next time, this has been the Sins Review. I'm Jackie Sins. Was it the boogeyman? As a matter of fact, it was.